So Facebook is, to my eye, in a tough spot because this is an audit that they participated in. It lasted for more than a year, a couple of years, and it finds fault with many of Facebook's practices and processes. So what from this audit itself would you like to see Facebook address and change? And what did you hear from Facebook on these issues just recently?
I think the largest issue is that these issues are so systemic and they are so ingrained in a lot of larger organizations that say that they're diverse and that they're focused on inclusion, but we still wouldn't be having this conversation in 2020 if that were the case. So what was interesting about the meeting yesterday was that their leadership from the marketing side was not even at the table. When I look at the leadership team of Facebook, there's no one that looks like me. And so how can you have conversations about different communities if everyone at the same table is having the same experience? And so one of the things, and we know that Facebook is being sued right now by some of their employees, from their Black employees, because of discrimination and lack of opportunities to move up and advance in the company. So unless conversations are really being held within the organization and commitment is being seen from the top, not just lip service, not just a nice statement you put on your website, not having a meeting for a PR, you know, to boost your PR efforts with civil rights organizations, but to really do what needs to happen, none of these things are going to change. And at the end of the day, right, unless profits are affected from Facebook, there's not going to be a change.
And Facebook, Mark Zuckerberg is saying that they don't respond to demands that have to do with revenue and boycotts, essentially. I'm paraphrasing there. But I'm curious, there are 10 demands, as I understand it, that the group brought. I don't expect you to read through all 10, but give me a sense of the specifics of what you're asking Facebook for.
Well, one of the things that they want definitely is to have someone at the table in leadership, in senior leadership, that has a voice around civil rights. Again, the people sitting around the table making the decisions all look the same, and there's no input from the communities that this issue is affecting. If you look at even the content areas, I mean, there's really lack of diversity in those areas as well. So making sure that there's a seat at the table at leadership, making sure that, you know, the ads that are being run and the hate content and the speech content and all those things are being tagged, they're being taken down. And although Facebook has said that they've done that, it really just isn't enough. And so I applaud the advertisers that have taken the first step, because it is going to be a long process to stop advertising for the month of July. But again, unless there's a commitment also from those advertisers to stay strong with this, unless it's hurting Facebook, and that's why Zuckerberg is saying, you know, we're not going to respond to a boycott, they're not hurt. A month of advertising from those corporations is not going to hurt Facebook. So what has to happen long-term is really going to be up to them and the corporate communities that are really, really focused on their brands being representative of diverse and inclusive communities.